Please be seated with the company. A sacred communion in which two people pledge to share all that they are and all that they will be with one another. Marriage is a sacramental act, an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace that has blossomed in the hearts of brothers and me. In the book of Genesis, God teaches us the life-giving connectedness of all creation and proclaims the very goodness of two people who join hearts and lives in love. The Apostle Paul writes, "If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all the mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith, so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. And it is in this love that you both come together this day to commit to share life together from now on. And so I ask you both now in the presence of God and family and friends gathered here, here and in our hearts, proclaim your intention to enter into union with each other and to share life together for all days. Rose, will you have Nathan to be your husband? To live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, no matter what may come, and turning from all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will. Nathan, will you have Rose to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her and comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, no matter what may come? And turning from all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live. If so, say, I will.
I will.
The joining marriage of Nathan and Rose unites their families and creates a new family. It's a particular joy for them that you're all present with them at this special moment, at this new beginning in their lives. Each of you, in your own ways, has richly blessed them. You bless them again this day with your presence, your affirmation, and your encouragement. Do all of you who represent their new family celebrate their union? And will you pray God's blessings upon them? If so, say, we will.
We will.
Will each of you do everything you can to uphold them, to care for them, help to make their marriage and their family one that is filled with love? If so, say, we will.
We will.
Let's pray together. And to love you. You love us unconditionally, and you teach us to love in the same way. You strengthen us, comfort us, and lead us. Lift our hearts in praise and thanksgiving for the many ways you bless us. And in special thanks this day for the wonderful marriage of these two dear people. Fill us with your love and power as we all join in affirming this solemn covenant and lifelong commitment between Rose and Nathan. We commend them to your grace and safekeeping in the name of Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. We have a reading from Scripture.
Ruth said, "Do not press me to leave you or to turn back from following you. Where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die. There will I be buried. May the Lord do this to me. And more as well, if even death parts me from you."
Nathan, repeat after me as you make your promise to Rose. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Nathan, take you, Rose.
I, Nathan, take you, Rose.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To belong to you.
To belong to you.
And to hold you with me.
To hold you with me.
From today forward.
From today forward.
For better days and harder days.
For better days and harder days.
For the rich times and the poor times.
For the rich times and the poor times.
When you are sick.
When you're sick.
And when you are well.
When you are well.
I will love you and cherish you. For all time.
For all time.
This is my most solemn promise.
This is my most solemn promise.
And Rose, repeat after me as you make your promise to Nathan, in the name of God. I, Rose, take you, Nathan, to be my husband, to belong to you, and to hold you with me. From today forward, better days and harder days, for the rich times and the poor times, when you are sick and when you are well, I will love you and cherish you for all time. This is my most solemn promise.
Reading from Ecclesiastes. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up the other. And woe to one who is alone and falls and does not have another to help. Again, if two lie together, they keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? And though one might prevail against another, two will withstand one. A threefold cord is not quickly broken.
These rings are symbols of that inward grace that has united the hearts and spirits of Nathan and Rose. In marriage, love so fills us that we see no longer one person in another, but truly become one new being, like the ring, the perfect circle that goes on forever. And yet, like these sacred spaces these rings enclose, marriage honors and celebrates the uniqueness of the beloved, making space in your togetherness to let the winds of the heavens dance between you, a moving sea between the shores of your souls. The love between Rose and Nathan is pure and beautiful, like the precious metal that the rings are made of. They are a sign to all the world that these two people have committed to share life together. Bless, O God, the giving of these rings, that they might be symbols of the everlasting love with which you bless Rose and Nathan in their marriage. Amen. Nathan, as you take Rose's ring and place it on her finger, repeat after me, Rose, I give you this ring.
Rose, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my promise.
As a sign of my promise.
That with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
I honor and love you.
In the name of the Father,
and of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And Rose, as you place Nathan's ring on his finger, repeat after me. Nathan, I give you this ring as a sign of my promise that with all that I am and all that I have, I honor and love you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite you to turn and face the altar. And I invite the congregation to stand as you are able and honor the one who brings us together in love. And we pray in the words that he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and give us our sins, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
All who wish to be Christ in this meal, all. We have gluten-free wafers that are available. You'll receive bread, and you'll have the option of buying more grape juice as you come through communion this day. Invite the wedding party to step down. Invite you all to be seated. Our communion. Thank you.